I know everybody is a bit shocked that Deb is not sitting here right now. But for those of you who don't know me, I'm Mr. Deb. I'm her husband, Brian. And today happens to be my birthday. And Deb told me that I could do whatever I wanted today, since I'm the birthday boy. And I said, I'd like to at least start your Instagram Live today. So she gave me the opportunity to sit in her amazing chair and just talk to you a couple of minutes about who Deb is and how important this is to her. My understanding is, get out of here. My understanding, this is Instagram number 50.
Week number 50.
And I just want to make sure everybody understands how important this is to Deb, that this has really gotten her through the pandemic, that everybody on this and your participation has been absolutely amazing. She is so excited to do this every week, and you guys have really gotten her through. So I want to extend my thanks for everything that you've done with her, and I know she's thrilled to be able to do this with you every week. Now, I know you're waiting for Deb, but in the meantime, I think she's got a video she wants to share with you, and I think she's going to try and do that right now. All right, you can stop that now. Well, thank you very much. I will now give you back to the hostess with the mostess, let you have your real Instagram Live back, but thank you for letting me crash your party. And I have a question for everybody that you have to guess whether today I am wearing hard pants or if I'm wearing soft pants. So you tell her what your guess is, and then she'll tell you if you're right or wrong. See ya.
Hey there, everybody. I know. It wasn't Mika. It was the best I could do. Sorry about that. Could you all hear the video? The video was compliments of Anna. She put that together there, and I hope that it didn't disrupt everything too much for you. Well, you know, it's our 50th week together doing this, and it is his birthday, so I thought he should be part of it and see exactly what it is that I'm doing down here every week when I get together with you all. So I appreciate your indulgence. Now he's going to go back to work and shaking his head saying, oh, she's insane. So since I missed the beginning there, I didn't get to say my usual hellos to everybody. And I see you all are here. Brian was awesome. He did a good job. That's good. I won't fire him yet then. I guess I'll keep him for a while. Salute, Laurie. Salute. Ciao, Chiara. Hi, Anna. Your video went over okay. I hope you all could hear it. Ciao, Gabriella. Ciao, Luisa. Salute, Fanny. How are you all doing this week? I'm trying to see your comments, but they're disappearing here. Let's see here. We'll try to catch up. Hi, CJ. Hi, Suzanne. Hi, Angela. hello, everybody. Hi, Miriam. So welcome. Here we are. Week 50. We made it. We're on the brink of a year of being together during this pandemic time. So I hope that you're all doing pretty well. As I do every week, I want to wish whoever may be celebrating a birthday, like my husband. He looks pretty good for 102, don't you think? He's doing okay. And if you're celebrating a birthday this week or have recently celebrated, happy birthday to you. I hope you have a chance to celebrate it with some family and friends. And if you're celebrating an anniversary, same, happy anniversary. So, I hope he didn't embarrass me too much. I heard what he said, but I was also focusing on trying to find that video and get that all set up. Hi, Wesley. Wesley is here. Hi. Salute, Florine. Sorry about that. Got a phone call there in the middle of this. That's never happened before. There we go. Let's see who else is here today. Melanie, salute Melanie. You want Brian back? Is that what you said? You want Brian always? Oh my goodness. I'll turn it over to him. I don't think he wants the job, however. Ciao Manuela. I'm a little bit disorganized. Got the phone call. I see I'm freezing a little bit now and then. Hi, Portugal. Hello. It's nice to see you here. Hi, Annick. Hi, Mika Argentina. I see you there. Thank you all for wishing Brian a happy birthday, like I said, and indulging me. So, I got to regroup and think about where we are here. Mika calling? No, I think it was just my mom, actually. But I think they were probably calling for Brian to wish him a happy birthday, too. But I'm sorry I'm freezing. I thought we were going to have good luck like we did last week, and unfortunately, it's not looking good. So let's get into this then. I'll try to get my act together now. What are we doing for his birthday? Nothing exciting really today. We're just going to, we're actually making homemade calzones tonight because that's what he wanted. And then I think this weekend we'll see our son and we'll have a cake and just a little family get together. Nothing too fancy this year, unfortunately. So let's see. Hello, everybody from Argentina. We have quite a few people from Argentina today. That's great. Great to see. What else? How else are you all doing today? A big hello from Shazad, who has a fancy dinner. How do you know this, Eric? I didn't see Shazad here. Did he tell you he was going out to a fancy dinner? The Mika Experience, UK. That's an interesting name. I don't think I've ever seen you here. Welcome. Carlotta says they're locked down there almost 90%. We are not, and we, you know, although we're sort of self-locking down, but we are able to go out and do a few things. I'm sorry to hear that, Carlotta. Eric says Shazad has posted photos of his fancy dinner. Salut from Montreal. Salut, Steffi Campo. Nice to see you here. I'm new in development Mika Tribute Act. Oh, okay. Okay, the Mika Experience. That's interesting. We'll see what you do in the future then. Let's see here. The situation's worsening in Italy. I'm worried about that here in the U.S. In fact, yesterday, Texas and Mississippi, two states that they're relaxing their restrictions, opening everything 100%, and getting rid of their mask mandates. You know, it's been mandatory to wear masks in public, and these two states have said, everything's getting better. We're gonna, you know, do away with that. And unfortunately, I think that's too soon. Even though there are some vaccines available, you know, less than 15% of the people have had the vaccine yet. CJ's mom's getting the vaccine on Friday. That is exciting. I wish my parents were getting the vaccine. They still don't have an appointment yet. Too soon in my opinion too, Camille. I'm glad I'm not near Texas, but you know those people will travel, and yeah, it's too soon. in my opinion, anyway. Thank you to all of the late well wishes for Brian, and hello to some of the people coming in just now. Hi, Eve, I see you there. Hope you all are doing okay, you new people coming in. In Germany, only people over 65 get the vaccine, yeah. Hopefully, you know, with the new Johnson & Johnson vaccine being approved, that's going to make more vaccine available in general, and let's hope, anyway. Emily, how has my week been? It was pretty good. We were a little bit stir crazy over the weekend, and we drove into the city. If you follow me on my personal Instagram account, you saw I posted a few pictures of Washington, D.C. It was a beautiful day, so that was nice, although we did not get out of the car at all because there were a lot of other people, and it seemed like it was too crowded in places, so we stayed in the car and just drove around. Hi, Shahzad, you just popped in. Well, nice to see you, and we'll see you again later sometime. I see, yeah, the vaccine there is not enough vaccine to go around yet, for sure. People are still waiting and waiting and waiting. But I am hopeful that in the next couple of weeks, there'll be more production and the vaccine will have a wider availability. Let's hope, anyway. Hi, Maggie. Ciao. I do have a list of things I wanted to talk to you about, so I'll jump into that. It may answer some of your questions that you're asking me here in the chat, and it will answer some of the questions that some of you have written to me privately. First of all, I know we were all very excited to see Mika's Paris poster project that sort of came out of the blue last week. And the posters are just gorgeous, and they're popping up all over Paris now. I have asked if anybody in Paris is lucky enough to see them to tag me in their photos or send them to me so I can repost them so that Mika can see, hopefully, you know, that his work is being spread out. And fortunately, some of you have done that, and it's kind of nice to see. A lot of you have asked about whether we can buy those posters, and they are obviously not available right now, but stay tuned because they, you know, we can never say never, they may be, and we think that the poster that Mika and Yasmin did, the Stay High, the For the Rite of Spring poster that Mika did, or that Mika and Yasmin did, would make a wonderful t-shirt design or a tote bag design. And I would definitely love to own that poster. And some of the others, too. I think they're all really, really interesting. So we are going to hope. So keep an eye out for that. I have let Mika's team know that there's an interest in them. So hopefully they'll be able to look into that, and maybe we will be lucky and they will produce those for us to purchase in the future. So yeah, keep your eyes peeled for that. Let's hope. Let's see. Other merchandise. A lot of you keep asking me about other merchandise. The store on MikaSounds.com was sort of out of commission for a while, and it's back now, but there's not really anything in it besides some CDs and music. And I hear that they will probably be restocking it with some new merchandise soon. So keep checking back for that. So that, you know, if there's something that you have been interested in buying, hopefully it'll pop up in there. Because as of now, really the only way you can get new Mika merchandise is to buy it on eBay. if somebody's selling something, or if you win it in a giveaway that, you know, we're having a giveaway of different shirts and pins and things like that. I don't know, Lisa, you may not be out of luck. We may see some merchandise resurface soon. So, you know, just keep checking, because they know that people are interested in buying things, and hopefully they will be able to work on getting something. Kasia, you say you missed the I Love Beirut shirt. You know, there is a website on Virgin Atlantic that still is selling the I Love Beirut shirt. At least it was a few days ago, the last time I checked. I don't have the link handy, but if you want to DM me, I'll find it and I'll send you the link, and you might be able to buy the I Love Beirut shirt there. So, if you're still interested in that, I noticed that link still does have some available. Other merchandise like CDs, DVDs, vinyls, things like that. They know that the desire is there for fans. You know, fans want to buy those kinds of things. However, I think that... I'm sorry, I keep freezing. I see that. I'm sorry. Anyway, I think the chances of us getting a vinyl or an actual physical CD or DVD of the Versailles concert or of the I Love Beirut concert, I think the chances of that are pretty slim. I don't think we're going to get any kind of physical product for those things. I think the digital download or the streaming that we got for the Versailles concert is about all we're going to be able to expect, unfortunately. But like I said before, never say never. They may surprise us, but I'm skeptical. I'm doubtful. Let's see what else. Talking about the Versailles concert, you may have seen that it was going to be broadcast on Italian TV, and that's true. We still don't have a date for that yet, though, but lucky Italians will be able to see that sometime soon. It will be on network. It's going to be on, or what channel it will be on in Italy, but when we get a date, we will definitely publish that. We'll post about it. Let's see what else. I have a long list, actually, of things people have asked me and I wanted to catch up on. A lot of people have asked me if I know anything more about Mika going to Canada. As you might know, Mika is going to be working as the artistic director for a Canadian program called Star Academy. And we've had some question about how much of his involvement would be, whether he would actually be on screen or whether just working behind the scenes. We still don't know exactly when he's going to get there. I think that COVID restrictions are playing havoc with the scheduling for that kind of thing, but he is definitely going to be on the program. He will be, you'll be able to see him, on Star Academy sometime in the next couple of weeks. I'm not sure exactly the date. Again, when I get a date, I will definitely post about it. What about Greece? Will his show be broadcast in Greece? There's nothing scheduled yet for that. I think they're trying to get it so that the whole world will be able to see it. But right now, all I know for sure is Italy. And let's see, what else? A couple people have asked me, you know, we do Zoom Zoom chats, MFC group chats on Zoom occasionally, and people have asked if Mika could join. I'm not going to say it will never happen, but he's really pretty busy right now, and I'm just not sure that's something I could even promise for any time in the future. So it may happen. Obviously, they know we would always love to see Mika here or anywhere, but I can't say that. So, you know, we can hope, but I wouldn't hold my breath waiting for it. let's see. Ciao, Maria Concetta. People just joining. It's good to see you here. Welcome. TikTok. I wanted to say a massive thank you to all of the fans who have joined TikTok to help promote Mika over there. And I have seen the threads that have been on Twitter where people are talking about how many, you know, millions of views you've gotten and how you feel like you've increased his streams on Spotify and YouTube. And I just think that's awesome. And as you probably know, Mika Fan Club has joined TikTok as well. And we're sort of joining in there to increase his presence over on TikTok. And I don't think Mika is going to be doing a TikTok anytime soon, you know, his own account. I think he's just so busy with so many other things. And TikTok really is time-consuming, I am discovering. It takes a lot of time to find the little video clip and figure out, you know, what's the best way to present it and the hashtags and try to get it trending. And so, yeah. I think it's a little too time-consuming right now for him, but maybe eventually. I didn't realize that David Dobrik's Into Song was a Mika song. You mean his intro song? I'll have to take a look, Emily. I haven't seen it. Yeah, some of the TikToks are so adorable. I get sucked in looking at all the cute puppy dog TikToks, and it's a major time suck, and it takes a lot of time to do it. But I do appreciate every fan that has, you know, taken this on and made it a thing, and really increased Mika's presence over there. That's kind of cool. Also, some people have asked me about when or if the fan club is going to do something for Mika's mother, you know, who passed away back in January. I think it's still too soon for us to really do anything. He knows that we care and he feels the love that we have been sending to him. So I think that's all we can do right now. I do have a couple of ideas that I may start to float and see for the future. But for right now, I think it's still too soon and everything is still too fresh. So I think we need to, you know, kind of back off from that. And going along with that is like when people are asking, like, will he do another cooking show or will he do, you know, I don't know, things like that. I think it's still, so I think we need to kind of chill about that and just wait a little while yet. Let's see here. A lot of animal TikToks are cruel. Yeah, some of them, I have to say, as soon as I start watching them, I'm turned off and I pass them by. But some of them are pretty cute, I gotta say. So let's see. Okay, that I think is most of the newsy type of things and the questions that I've been getting. Just looking over my little notes here. Um, somebody asked me about Mika doing a show, or since he had had plans to do shows like in Verona and other things, if he's going to go back and rebook those. And I think the answer to that is probably no. I mean, he may do the theater in Verona again at some point down the road, but it's not like he's going to rebook it and do the show that he was planning to do before. I think he's kind of moved on from the Revelation tour, and I think, you know, everything that we see going forward is going to be new stuff. So I think that, as far as like trying to catch up on things that he missed, I don't think that's going to happen. I do want a puppy, and I have actually been, Florine asked about the puppy. I have been looking for a puppy. I have been in talks with a breeder, who has had a couple litters of puppies, and she sent me pictures. That's as far as we've gone. The puppies are newborn. It'll be like 8 weeks or so before they're weaned. So that's as far as we've gotten, as far as that goes. And if I get a puppy, he will definitely be introduced to you. So, would I not adopt a dog? The problem is, Brian, my husband, he has allergies. And so we have to be really careful about what kind of dog we get. So we have had in the past a wire fox terrier, and they do not shed very much. And so that's probably the kind of dog that we would want to get again. And when you go to the rescue places or the Humane Society or whatever, they mostly have large breed dogs, and lots of things like, German Shepherds or Pit Bulls or Rottweilers and things that are much bigger than we want, for one thing, and shed a lot, and we'd be kind of afraid about the allergy problem. It's kind of like we know that he can tolerate the terrier, so that's kind of what we're sticking with. So it's not that we wouldn't want to adopt an adult dog or a rescue dog. I don't think that Mika is doing San Remo because isn't it going on right now? And he's getting ready to go to Canada, I think. So I don't think he's going, and I think it would have been announced by now. So I don't think he's doing San Remo. What else here? A beagle. My neighbors had a beagle, and that was a problem. It shed quite a bit because we would watch it occasionally, and it turned out to be a real problem. No beagles. A horse. A horse is not going to fit in my house, Fanny. No, we can't keep a horse here. Let's see. I think that is pretty much all I had prepared to talk to you about. There's a lot of you here today, so I'm going to see if I can bring some of you into the conversation. I keep freezing, and hopefully things will stabilize enough that we can chat with other people. So we'll give it a try here. Deanna says her coworker had smooth fox terriers. They are really cute too, and very smart dogs. Very, very smart. Let's see. We can get somebody to come in. Oh, there's a lot of you here today. And I'm gonna start with Anna because she was so to give me that video for Brian's birthday. I think he was surprised. So let's see if we can connect with her. Anna, we're not connecting. Ah, there we are. Hi.
Hello, Dan.
How are you?
Well, I'm fine, thank you.
I think it went okay. I think he was surprised.
I hope so.
Yeah, I think he was. And I think he was definitely a little embarrassed. So that was good too.
It was a point.
Yes. Yes, that's always a good thing.
Yes, you know, I had this idea a long time ago when we started to talk about this 15th meeting. So I said, it would be nice to do something. And you said that your husband has his birthday.
Yes.
So it's great, great. So I have to find this video. Mika done several times. He done this.
Yes.
For his sisters. So.
Well, that was perfect. It was perfect. So.
That's why I was asking his name, your husband's name, because it was very important.
Well, he is anonymous no more. He can't hide now. He's
no more.
Yeah.
But anyway, as I told you in private, that he's. Every time he's present somewhere in your house, so
yes,
he's a part of the family.
Yes, he is, and he knows. I mean, I tell him what's going on, and I think he probably knows a lot of your names because I mm-hmm. talk about you. So, so yeah, he probably felt right at home. I think it was kind of interesting though because he has never. I don't think he's ever done an Instagram live. He does. Microsoft Teams for work, and I think he does WebEx for work, but he's never done this. So I think to see the text coming up, and I think that was a education for him. So that was good.
Yes. Anyway, I think he was really brave to sit, take your seat, and
yes,
and talk to us.
Yes, he was. He was funny because at first he was just like, well, I'll just join the live and I'll just text. Mm-hmm. And I was like, no, you have to be on camera. So I'm glad that you did. And I appreciate your effort. That was great. So thank you.
It was a big fun for me.
Thanks. So how are you otherwise?
Oh, great. Actually, last week I was very busy at work. Today we finished the job. So. I'm happy now.
Oh, good. You can breathe.
Yes. Yes, now I can breathe. I start to be creative again. So, I will
piano?
Show you something.
I was going to say, how is the piano?
The piano, I did not have much time to practice, but from time to time, I do some, you know, with my fingers, because you have to practice with fingers. At the beginning, it's very hard because you don't know where is the notes
right.
you are looking for.
Right.
But, you know, I have another idea. This is the Mika family idea, actually, because when I read the comments, we're talking about this tour bus where we come together mm-hmm. to follow Mika for the next concert. And I had this idea to create a Revelation Tour Monopoly.
Oh, my goodness.
Let's That's call great. It like this.
That's
so
great.
I want to show you. I have a sketch already.
Okay.
This is the Revelation Tour, so it starts in London and it's finished in Strasbourg.
Okay.
So now I have to work on details, and when it's ready, I would like to make it possible to print
right. yeah.
for everybody with cards. And like this, everybody can print the game and play.
We can all print our own, yes. And we can use our own Monopoly money. And...
Well, it will be not about money, actually, because, you know, Mika and money,
that's true.
It's not for us. So we will gather some items. We can go to the shop to buy a T-shirt, for example, or a poster.
Okay.
We can collect fan action items. And we'll collect points.
Okay.
And the point is to that everybody have to finish the game. So it's not the game about who is the winner, because I'm the first in Strasbourg, mm-hmm. but everybody has to finish the game. And then we calculate the points.
Okay.
For every subject, every object, there will be some points. And we This is my idea for the moment. So I have to work on details, and then we can play. So we can imagine we are in the tour bus and we are traveling from one town to another.
For somebody who asked if the MFC tour bus was a real thing, and I wanted to just say it's not. It's just a fantasy that we have, that we will all go together on a tour bus to see Mika once the pandemic is over. So. Mikapoli.
Yes, and we play the game Revelation Tour.
That's right. Mikapoli, people are saying. Mikapoli. Mikapoly. There we go. I think it's a great idea. We'll have different game pieces. We can each be different things. I have to think of what would we be. I guess everybody could choose their own. Somebody, yes, Michelle says, have a Valentino store. We could have a store on the way. Yes, a swatch store.
Ah, a swatch store. Yes, it's a good idea. Yeah. Or maybe Valentino, maybe not, but swatch, yes.
Maybe
swatch,
that will be my token, a swatch watch. I can have my little swatch watch to move around the board. We could have fun with that. That would be fun. So
I hope I will finish soon, so I will show you the effect.
All right.
Final product.
That's awesome. Yeah, Louboutins. Somebody says Louboutins. Definitely.
Oh yeah, shoes.
Paint the little shoes, the bottom, paint them red. That was good. Yeah. Well, thank you for sharing, and thank you for making my husband's birthday bright. I'm sure.
It's really funny. So thank you, Deb.
Thank you.
We'll thank
talk,
everybody.
We'll
bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay. There. Yes, if you get the most points, I don't know, if you get the most points, you get front row, you get, I don't know. Sheet music, I do not know. I don't know. I know there is Mika sheet music floating around, but I don't know about that particular song, which I can't say the name of. And so I don't know. Let's see here. Let's see who else is around. I can't, why is that not working? Where did you all go? Questions? I'm having technical difficulties here. I'm sorry. Here it is. Okay. Let's see who else is here. Pierre, last time you were here, Pierre, we could not connect. Let's see if we have any luck today. We are trying to connect with Pierre. Are we having any luck? Normally it tells me whether it's connecting or not, and I don't see anything happening here. I don't know, Pierre. It seems like we're not connecting for some reason. Oh, there you are.
Hello.
There you are.
How are you?
I am well. How have you been?
I'm good too. It's been a long time.
Yes. Well, last time we tried to connect and it wouldn't, we had, I don't know, bad internet or something, and I couldn't bring you in. So.
Oh, I don't remember that.
Yeah, it was a few weeks ago, but
yes, a few months ago, maybe.
it all blends together after a while.
Yes.
So how are you doing? What are you doing?
Now I'm playing piano.
Okay.
And I'm working a lot on new Mika songs.
Aha. Okay.
Yes.
Do you have a Mika song for us today?
Yes.
Are you prepared?
I will play Any Other World, maybe.
Oh, okay. That sounds great.
Yes. Okay.
This is an unexpected treat. Great.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. You will hear the piano?
I can hear it.
Nice. Let's go. Merci bien, c'est gentil.
Ah, very, very nice. Merci beaucoup.
Mais de
we
rien.
Enjoyed it. Enjoyed
with,
it very
with
much.
With pleasure.
Ah. So and you have.
Last week I bought this book. This is I don't know how to say in English, but that like this of all the old song of the third album. And you don't see it.
Yes.
But it's very, very good to learn the piano for the songs.
Great. Great.
Yes.
Well, yeah, I know people often ask about how you find the sheet music. Did you just find it at a bookstore or?
For the piano?
Yeah.
A big part of songs, we're just with my ears.
Okay.
Yes, I listen very, very much times the songs, three, four, five times, and I try to find notes on the keyboard, the piano, and after I try practice a lot, and mm-hmm. at the end, it's good.
That's a very, very special talent to be able to hear it and then play it without the music.
Yeah, and I never had a piano lesson with a teacher and for the voice, no teacher wow. for the voice too, and all with ears and watch and listen a lot to Mika's songs.
Wow, well done. Well done. I'm impressed.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for giving us a treat.
Thank you for your invitation.
On our 50th week. That's great.
Yes. Thank you so much. And
thank you.
See you very soon.
Yes, we'll see you soon. Thank you.
Bye-bye for France. Salut tout le monde.
Bye-bye. Okay. Wow. Well, that was unexpected. I was not, I have been hoping that, you know, we could do some more of the Mika fans have talent. That was nice. And I'm glad we were able to connect because, like I said, last time we just didn't have any luck. Let's see who else is here that we can bring in to speak. I'm going to try to bring in Salsarina. Let's see if we can get you in here. Because I don't. There you are. Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. You?
I'm okay. Is it? I think I've probably asked you before, but I forget. Is it Ina or Ina?
Ina. Yes. Ina.
Okay, and you're in Bulgaria, right?
In Bulgaria, right.
Yeah. So how are things there? How are you?
I'm good, but the things with the COVID situation now, it's a little bit worse. It's 14-15% of all the tests is positive.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. Yeah, so we are very careful now.
I guess so.
It was a little bit better in 2 weeks ago, but now it's not very good. But it's okay.
Yeah.
There's no more vaccines.
No. Well, soon hopefully the vaccine will get out to more people. But do you work outside the home or are you working at home?
For now, I'm at home, but next week I have to go because I have a project. So I work in a producing company.
Okay.
So we have one project and I have to go on the set. So it's not impossible to work from home.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Well, so what are you doing in the meantime? I mean, are you... I guess, able to, I don't know, do you have children? Do you have to teach your children at home or?
Yes, my son is 13 years old, but they go to school.
Oh, they are.
A month ago, they go to school and it's okay for now.
Okay.
Yeah.
I know a lot of places here are doing what they call hybrid, where the kids go to school a day or two and then they stay home a day or two and do it from home.
Yes.
Remote learning.
It's similar here. They go to school for 2 weeks and then for 4 weeks they are at home.
Oh, okay. I see.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Crazy times. Crazy times to live in. So, yeah.
Really.
But are you listening to lots of Mika music and have you been able to see the Versailles concert? And
yes, I downloaded it, so in my car now it's only the Versailles concert.
I understand. I'm doing the same, so I understand.
And my son is learning bass, so in a couple of weeks, I think I will send you Grace Kelly with my son on the bass.
That'll be good. I'll be interested to hear that. That will be fun.
Yeah.
So, what else is keeping you busy then? What else are you doing from home or?
Yeah, I'm working a lot now, but in the free time I paint.
Oh, do you? Good.
Yes, my son is with the music, me with paintings.
That's great. I'm not talented with a paintbrush or a pencil, or I'm not artistic like that at all. So I am always impressed by people who are. So
yeah, and we speak a lot of Italian because my husband is Italian.
Ah, okay.
So we speak with my son in Italian. His teacher, bass teacher, speaks in Italian. So we try to keep our languages.
That's excellent. I admire that. I wish that my family had done that, because I am half Italian and I studied Italian in college, but I have nobody to speak to practice with, so I forget it. And I think that's so good that you do that for your son. Yeah. That's great to be multilingual. I think it's really good for your brain.
Yes, of course. Yeah,
it really helps when you go out and meet people and you can speak other languages. So
yes,
good job. So well thank you very much for joining
thank you,
us
Dad.
This week. It's I'm glad we were able to bring you in and have a little
Me
chat
too.
And
yeah.
Take good care and good luck with your work and going out
thank you
into the world there. So
thank you very much.
We'll talk to you again soon.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay. Let's see here. It's just a little bit before 3. I think I can maybe bring in one more person. We'll run over a little bit. We'll run over a little bit this week, but we'll see here. I think Angela, if we're connecting with Angela, I think.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Good. I won't take up too much time. I just wanted to thank you for the shout out earlier today.
Sure. I had saved that a long time ago, I guess, when you first published that picture, and I ran across it today and I was like, that's perfect. I like alliteration. So it was
right.
I'm tired of way back Wednesday. So we can do it Wednesday.
Yes. And I need that advice this week as well on myself. So
yeah. Yeah, I think we all do as we come up on the anniversary of, I think, really when everything shut down for most of us, right? At least I know for me, I mark the anniversary as like March 12th. That was the last date that we went out to dinner. Okay. And then the next day, March 13th, was a Friday.
Was the announcement.
It was the first day when my husband didn't go into work, and they were basically like, yeah, the office is closed. And so that's, yeah. And as we come up on that anniversary, it's like,
I know, right? It was Friday the 13th. It was my brother's birthday.
Ah.
I was in a drive-through and I read the announcement that Mika was counseling everything.
Right.
And I was a mess.
Yeah. Yeah, we had plans. Everybody had plans. Mm-hmm. And just like that, it goes. Like you said, everything changes.
That's
in
right.
The blink of an eye. So.
And kudos to Anna and kudos to Pierre. Beautiful.
Yeah. Yeah. So. there's a lot of, you know, when you, there's a saying that necessity is the mother of invention. Mm-hmm. And I guess this is forcing us all to sort of dig deep and look for other talents and other skills that we might have and other ways to entertain ourselves. So
yeah, I wish they'd find it. They have, I have no talent. I'm not a drop.
You do. You do. So, well, thank you for joining us. And I'm glad to see that you're looking well and hanging in there.
Yes. And, keeping busy. That's for sure.
Good. That's my motto. Keep too busy to think. If you have free time to think, then you're hosed because you're too much and that's bad.
I love that.
Yeah. So, all right. Well, you take good care and we'll talk to you again soon. Bye-bye. Okay. Yeah. Eric says his talent is drinking. Let me say that is a skill that I have honed over the last year. Drinking. Yeah, it's not a good one. Not a good, necessarily a good one to have, but yeah. It's the end of the hour. We're right up almost at an exactly at an hour here. So I think I'm going to wrap up because it always takes me a long time to say goodbye. But I did want to say, speaking of the anniversary coming up, in 2 weeks, that will be week 52. And it'll be St. Patrick's Day. And so I thought we would do kind of a bigger celebration. Even though it's not the actual anniversary of our first Instagram Live, our first Instagram Live was on April 3rd, I think. But, I mean, the fan club's Instagram Live was April 3rd. But March 17th is the 52nd week of this whole pandemic thing. So, and since it's St. Patrick's Day, I think we'll do a little St. Patrick's Day party. And I will have a couple competitions. And I think that week also, I will do a couple Instagram Lives at different times for the different time zones. I keep saying I'm going to do that, but I am going to do it for real in week 52 to get people that are on the West Coast of the US and maybe some people from the Asian countries and from Australia, New Zealand, and try to reach out to all of those different time zones. So look for several different times of Instagram Lives and, like I said, some competitions and just a general celebration of making it through 52 weeks. And maybe we'll see if there's some other things we can come up with. If anybody would like to try to think of something special that they maybe want to share with us in 2 weeks, give you 2 weeks to prepare. And what else? Yeah, Instagram Live Marathon. Eric, I actually did think of that. I thought about how long could I do it. I think Instagram Live, Instagram will let you go 4 hours. I don't know if I could do 4 hours. I think I would probably just keel over. But maybe we can think about that. Maybe that's what we could do instead of different time zones, but that's, I don't know, it's kind of ambitious. we'll see. I'm trying to think if there was, it seems like there was one other thing I was going to say. The other thing I was thinking I might do also is schedule a time for a text chat on our website, MikaFanClub.com. As I mentioned last week, we have a chat box there and we should use it. And so maybe I'll schedule a time with a topic and we can, if you're into text chatting, we can go over there and we can do that for maybe an hour. We can schedule that for week 52 also to sort of tie in the forum with our social media type presence. So a 4-hour file would be kind of big, because even 1 hour is, you know, gigabyte or something. It's kind of big. So you're right, 4-hour file might be too much. So anyway, so just some things to think about. We've got 2 weeks to sort of let the ideas simmer and think about what we're going to do. Let me know if you have any suggestions. Send me a DM here or write to me on mikafanclub.com, and we can talk. And until then, until next week, please take care of yourselves. Stay safe. Wear your mask. Social distance. It's too soon to relax too much. Things are getting better. I think the light is at the end of the tunnel. But let's not get too crazy and loose. And let's focus on, we've got this far, let's not mess it up, I guess is what I'm saying. We made it this far, let's not go crazy and mess it up now. So stay safe and come back to me next week, and we'll see you here for week 51. And take care, everybody, until then. And also, well, one more time, thank you for being so kind to my husband. And I'll think of you all when we're celebrating. We're toasting him with a glass of wine tonight. So take good care. I'll talk to you all then. Bye.